Welcome to Digital Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you Sigma Delta ADC in this video. And to understand Sigma Delta ADC, these are my session outlines, where first I'll be going to discuss basics of Sigma Delta ADC. After that, I'll be explaining structure of Sigma Delta ADC. After that, we will see working of Sigma Delta ADC. And based on its working, we will see flowchart of Sigma Delta ADC. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of Sigma Delta ADC. So when we talk about Sigma Delta ADC, that is high resolution ADC. So Sigma Delta ADC is very high resolution ADC. It uses comparator and integrator. Comparator is referred as delta and integrator is referred as sigma. See, integrator means what? Summation means sigma, and comparator provides difference means delta. So based on comparator and integrator, its name is sigma delta, right? Here we integrate analog and digital circuit in a same IC by using sigma delta ADC. So you'll be finding analog components as well as digital components are integrated in a same IC by using sigma delta ADC. So let us see the structure which is there with sigma delta ADC. So in its structure, here we have input analog signal, let us say that is X1, that we will be giving it to comparator, and positive terminal is connected with input analog voltage, and negative terminal, that I will show you later how it is connected. So here in between these two terminal, whatever difference is there, that will be there at output side, which will be X2. So if I say over here X5 is our signal, then X2 will be difference in between X1 and X5. So X2 will be X1 minus X5. This X2, that we give it to integrator. So here after integration, our output will be X3. Now you see X3, that will be previous value of X3 plus X2, right? So for example, at nth minus 1 sample, X3, that will be X3 is equals to X3 of n minus 1 sample plus X2. So later on in flowchart even you will be getting how it is happening. This X3, that we give it to 1-bit analog to digital converter, where here there will be ground and X3 is compared with 0. So if X3 is positive, this X4 will be logic 1. If X3 is negative, then X4, that will be logic 0, that we can say as per this comparator, which is what, 1-bit analog to digital converter. So if X3 is positive, X4 will be digital data 1, as if X3 is negative, then X4 will be logic 0. And this is what we are taking it with feedback. And here one, we have 1-bit digital to analog converter that will be generating X5 output. Now you see in this digital to analog converter, if input is logic 1, then here there will be plus 1 voltage that we will be generating at X5. And if this input is logic 0, in that case, output will be plus minus 1 voltage, which is there at X5. Right. So that is how complete circuit is there. Now one can easily understand this working based on its flowchart. So let me explain you the flowchart first, so that working will be a bit more clear. So here in this flowchart, we have X1, that is our input analog voltage. And in first comparator, X2 is difference in between feedback and X1, right? So X2 is equals to X1 minus X5, where X5 is feedback. And that X5, that can be plus 1 or minus 1 based on feedback digital data. And that is that after that we give this signal to integrator. So integrator performs X2 plus previous data of X3, right? And that X3, that is what we are checking whether it is positive or negative. If it is positive, in that case we say this is what, digital data, which is logic 1, which is X4. And if this X3 is negative, in that case, we say this is what, digital data, which is logic 0. And this digital data, that we take it at output side. And again, that we give it to feedback, where in feedback we have 1-bit digital to analog converter, and if logic 1 is there at X4 side, it generates X5 with +1 voltage, and if logic 0 is there at X4, then this digital to analog converter will generate -1 voltage. And this X5 that we give it to feedback over here with X2, right? So you'll be finding this process continuously revolved with respect to clock, and at X4 we'll be having digital output data, right? So here you'll be finding with respect to clock we will be generating digital data, and this is what very high resolution ADC, right? Where you don't need to have many clocks. With respect to clock, automatically digital data will come at output side, right? So this is all about Sigma Delta ADC. I hope that you have understood this video.